is 9 minutes before nine, and that, of course, is Islands in the Stream, a big hit last year, sung by Dolly Parton and Kenny Rogers and written by the Gibb brothers, Morris, Robin, and Barry. And last night, Islands in the Stream was named Song of the Year by the music industry's largest licensing organization, EMI. And Morris and Robin Gibb, two of the very versatile Bee Gees, are with us this morning, and good morning.
Hi.
I am told that you were very surprised that you won this last night. Is that true?
Well, first of all, it was BMI, not EMI.
BMI, that's
BMI,
right.
The record company, okay. BMI is different.
Okay.
Yeah, it's the BMI, which is the most popular song of the year, which is Island in the Stream.
Yeah, it's the most played song.
It's the most
right?
played,
okay.
Yeah. And it quite surprised us amongst, especially as we didn't expect this award. We knew we would probably get some citations and things and little pins that tell you how many citations you have, things like that. But the last thing we expected was this award.
Well, this is the Song of the Year award. But the Song of the Year award is usually the biggest award of the night, so nobody expects to get that award. You're never told in advance.
Yeah. Well, but this is the third time, right? The third time?
Yeah,
I think so,
yeah.
Yeah. You are all doing things, you know, you're going in your own direction now. You're scoring movies, or you're recording independently. Everybody wants to know, though, what about the Bee Gees? The Bee Gees as a group, how important are they to you?
Well, the Bee Gees are very important to us because the Bee Gees, if it wasn't for Bee Gees, we couldn't do the things that we're separately doing now. I mean,
But are you going to do another album? Are you going to go back out on tour?
I think, this is, we're doing pretty much what a lot of groups have done, like the Eagles and Fleetwood Mac, who have gone out and made separate albums and then got back together again. I mean, not the Eagles so far, but definitely Fleetwood Mac and Genesis, where, as in the case of Phil Collins, where they've got together and after they've made solo projects.
Yeah. So in the next year, do you think you'll record?
Oh, sure.
And you go back out on tour?
Oh, yes. That's what we're looking forward to doing.
Okay. Now, in the meantime, though, you've got a new album out. You've got a new video. This is, and we've got something to show from Boys Do Fall in Love. And I should say, Morris, you do sing backup too, right?
Well, we wrote it together.
We wrote it together. He co-produced it with you. So let's take a look right now at a little bit of Boys Do Fall in Love. Did you have fun doing that?
Fun, yes, but it was a long day. We started at 8 in the morning till 8 the following morning.
Did that in London.
Yeah.
Now, Morris did co-write with you.
Yes,
and he did
production.
Some backup. But this is yours. This is your album. How important is that for you to establish independently your album?
Well, what I really get off on is the fact that people will appreciate the music. It's a project, and it's both our projects, whether it's my name on it or not. And it's a project. I'm not looking really for a sort of Robin Gibb profile. What I'm looking for is a separate identity from the Bee Gees, the same way as Barry, my brother, would be looking for a separate identity when he brings out his solo album.
Yeah.
It's important, and therefore we can show that there can be a separate identity from the Bee Gees at any given time.
Yeah,
there's three people, not just...
And while you both have your albums coming out, you're scoring.
Yes, I've just scored a film called Agreed Apart, which will be out in October with Kathleen Turner and Ruud Gohoa. And that was fun because it spent a lot of time, a lot of work, but I was doing that in between writing with Barry and doing Robin's album. So I was like in the middle, and it was great fun for me. I've enjoyed the last year. We've had a great time together.
Other than that, you guys have nothing going on, right?
At the moment, yeah.
Congratulations on last night.
Thank
you.
Thanks very much.
Once again, that is Islands in the Stream, one of the big hits of 1983, written by the Gibb brothers, who are here to say goodbye, along with David and me. And Kenny Rogers and Dolly Parton sing the song, of course. And we have a little bit of a surprise for you, too. Can we bring in our...
Oh, great.
I would get up this time of day for guys like this, and you.
Good morning, Dolly. How are you?
Nice to
see you.
How are you?
Good
to see you.
Good
to see you
again.
Hi, Dolly.
Pull up a couch.
Pull up a couch.
Pull up a couch.
Pull up a couch. Morris, you were there when Dolly and Kenny recorded, right?
Well, the wonderful thing about when you're writing songs is to see the actual song materialize in front of your eyes of how you imagined it. And when we imagined, particularly Dolly singing with Kenny, and I was sitting in the booth watching you two sing. It was just like, well, this song's been born now. It's just like it's the baby grown up.
Dolly, what is it like? I mean, that process. He says, they look forward to saying, okay, how will it come to life? What is it like for you when you look at them on the page? How is it different from what you imagined it would be when you go to record something?
Well, I don't think singers ever really get out of a song what the writer actually puts in it, because I know I write, and although I'm always very proud of the things that other people record of mine, it's always a different interpretation. You just always hope that you're getting, you know, out of it and putting into it what you should. And this was such a wonderful song, one of the biggest songs of my whole career, and it just really...
As writers, or either of you, do you ever get surprised that somebody finds new stuff in a song that you didn't know was there yourself when you wrote it?
Oh, well, definitely the way, the stylist of the vocalist. I mean, I think Dolly's got one of the best female voices in the world.
Thank you.
And that's genuine.
Very
I always have done. And I think the way you interpreted some of the lines was, you know, adding something that was never there. It was great.
But it was so easy because they had demoed the song for us, and we stole a lot of their good licks. I mean, anybody can sound good. You've got the Bee Gees already there.
Well, Boris, you originally wrote it for Kenny, and then all of a sudden realized this is a great duet, right?
Well, the three of us, when we were writing it, we were saying it would be nice to have a duet on the album of Kenny's, you know, but we didn't think it was another person, but we thought it was the queen of the same field of Kenny. It was wonderful to put them together.
They never recorded
Dolly
together.
Dolly, just
never
played you
together.
Off with the music of Marvin Hamlisch. Thank you. Make it a good day today.
Goody.
Oh, good old Marvin.